Flora and fauna in Satisfactory have the tendency to fight back, especially when it comes to consuming your inventory space. Usually, you want to convert that into something useful. Better yet, when it happens automatically. And here's the solution. You are looking at fully modular blueprint biowaste factory in Satisfactory. You just insert flora and fauna items into the container, then they are being automatically sorted and converted, and produced items go into designated personal storage containers. If any inserted raw item is non-native for the system, it is being rejected by the system into the protection bin. Base module is fully autonomous and convert power slugs, wood, leaves, mycelia, alien remains and flower petals. And with extra connection of water, iron and coal, second module can expand this base functionality with extra production of packaged liquid biofuel, gas filters and alien DNA for instant awesome sync. And as extra feature, second module can convert normal gas filters into iodine filters if necessary. Yep, this is huge and complex system for flora and fauna automation in Satisfactory. This is the third iteration of my flora and fauna automation factory. And, well, it is the result of hundreds of hours in meticulous blueprint design. In this video, I would explain the evolution of this idea. I would break down both basic principles for new Satisfactory players and higher level logic for Satisfactory players that are looking to replicate this design on their own. And as always, thanks to continuous support of my channel members, my blueprints are available for free in the pinned comment down below. Huge props for everyone making this possible. Flora and fauna conversion in Satisfactory is very straightforward on the base level. You plop several constructors dedicated to every item and just insert every resource manually. I bet every new Satisfactory player makes some sort of automation for early power with biomass burners. This half automation is okay for early game, but very soon it gets quite annoying. As soon as you unlock smart splitters, you can easily make simple sorting system with so-called sushi belt. Just dump every item into single container, and smart splitter would redirect items from one belt to respected machinery. But at this point, several issues can arise. First issue is capacity of machinery. For example, single constructor cannot convert more than one stack of wood. And in majority of cases, you will dump quite a lot of different biomaterials into a system like this. Several stacks of wood will result in a system clogging up until all wood is being processed by a single machine. Not ideal. Once again, in this system, all other converters will wait for one single machine to do full conversion of single material. Well, it's not even the limit of your belts, it is the limit of, well, one single constructor, for example. While this happens when any non-defined item is set as the setting in the smart splitter, use of overflow setting in the smart splitter will just flush all stacks of wood above one fitting into the machinery. Not ideal. While one can plop dozens of machines for the same item, it is not really efficient in department of space. And if you want to make blueprint factory, space is quite relevant topic. To avoid machinery spam, there is simple and elegant solution in form of container buffer right after smart splitter. So even when there are several stacks of one item on the belt, those stacks can easily wait in storage container buffer before dedicated machinery. So in simple words, simple buffer after each smart splitter clears the way for other items on the sushi belt. Then there is the second issue with any non-native item on the sushi belt. It is rather easy to put something extra into the storage container, something that does not fit into this factory. And in this case, sushi belt will eventually clog, starting at the end of the belt. To avoid this issue, one need to use overflow setting on every smart splitter in the chain, including the last one in the chain. Then, use of protection storage container is required, well, in the end of the sushi belt. As a side benefit, systems like this gain extra protection from the overflow of native items. So not only non-native items would go into protection bin, but also in the case when storage is full, all extra raw resources would bounce back into the protection bin. And this is your logical basis to create basic biowaste or biomass processor. Now, let's explore advanced solution for extra functionality. Alright, there are multitude of flora and fauna items one can convert. Most basic items are solid biofuel, power shards, color cartridges, alien protein, alien DNA, and fabric. Also, one can easily make coal from processed biomass. So these are the items that do not require any extra input. Then, there are advanced items that require extra resources for conversion. These are packaged liquid biofuel, gas filters, and iodine filters. Extra items for conversions are rubber, quickwire, aluminum casing, and canisters. I know for sure that this factory is not the place for production of aluminum casing, rubber, and quickwire. It just makes more sense to either import those items or simply to put those items into the container processor, just like we do with the flora and fauna remains. Frankly, it is way easier to expand sushi belt than, well, to make three extra external connections and to make connection between modules, you know, just a lot of complexity there when expanding sushi belt is way easier. At the same time, with steel canister alternative recipe for canisters, we can totally make those on board. If you consider a possibility to make coal from biomass, we can potentially ignore coal connection for steel and gas filter production. So with this knowledge, we have rough outline when it comes to production units in this factory. Everything will not fit into a single 4x4 period. I know that I can ignore buffers for 4 types of alien remains and power slugs. So this is like what? 7 less container buffers? This will leave us with total of 11 buffers for processed items in such a system. Then there's the refinery for liquid biofuel, 2 manufacturers for filters, awesome sink for alien DNA, and quite a lot of constructors with single assembler and single packager. I decided to fit all big machinery into the second module, and frankly, all those items are advanced items. And then there is the case of stacking, and for that, well, vertical stacking was quite a natural pick. In the first module, I want to have 6 rows of containers facing one side. These need to include big industrial storage container for processor itself, big containers for solid biofuel and packaged liquid biofuel, and small containers for everything else, including the protection bin. Then, placing 3 power slug constructors on the start of the chain sounds as a reasonable option. Over here, I'm using vertical aligned manifold to place buffers for leaves, wood, and flower petals on the second floor. This also allows for use of, well, 2 smart splitter outputs at the same time, so this is like small win-win in space and, well, material department. Usually in my playthroughs of Satisfactory, wood is the most abundant resource, followed by leaves and mycelia. This is why I prefer to convert wood into the solid biofuel and leaves with mycelia into fabric. Also, wood conversion ratio into biomass is quite high and allow for higher output ratio. Next, there was the decision to make optional coal production with the power switch and, well, wood conversion. So, here's the thing. Wood to biomass to solid biofuel constructors have exact ratios, and unless storage is full, wood never overflow. So, I just placed smart splitter after wood to biomass to solid biofuel constructors, and with overflow setting on the smart splitter and power off on 2 solid biofuel constructors, well, in this case, biomass would just flow into 2 constructors next after the smart splitter, and these constructors are for biomass to coal conversion. So, in the end of the day, there are 2 modes of the wood conversion. First, when we have the power switch on, we have solid biofuel production, but when we have the power switch off, then there would be conversion of wood into the coal. Simple as that. Then on the second floor, I also placed buffer for leaves to biomass conversion before fabric assembler. On the third floor, there is the space for fabric assembler, mycelia buffer, and all 4 alien remains to alien protein constructors. And then there is totally enough space for 1 foundry and constructor to make steel canisters. While this is not direct function of module A, placing those 2 machines is very important to free up space in the module B, and in any case, well, if you do not connect iron and coal, or you do not produce coal on the board, well, those 2 machines will do nothing, so this doesn't bloat the module A and it's still fully, well, independent. So, in the end of the day, for the module A, I need to make connections of iron, optional connection of coal with merger if internal coal production is activated, connection for water, and also intakes for filters, and packaged liquid biofuel from the module B, because, well, those items would be produced in the module B, but I will store them in module A. So yeah, quite a lot of connections. But this is not the end. Also over here, it is important to make convenient set of connections for the second module sushi belt extension. So, For the processor unit, I need to make extra splits to module B for rubber, quick wire and aluminum casings. There are cases of 2 and even 3 stage conversions in this system for the processor. So, solid biofuel would convert into the packaged liquid biofuel. So this is like 2-stage process. First you convert wood into the solid biofuel, and then you can convert solid biofuel into the packaged liquid biofuel. Then there is the case with the fabric that would convert into the gas filters. There is also alien protein converted into alien DNA, and then it's automatically sunk into the awesome sink. And finally there is the 3-stage conversion for the gas filters, when it can be converted into iodine filters on top of, well, first stage conversion of, well, first fabric, and then fabric into the gas filters, and then gas filters into iodine filters. Yeah, quite a complex system. While in theory I can try to make advanced logic with priority power switches to avoid 2 and 3 stage process like I did with my remote or a remote storage system, well, let's be real. System like this will require way more than just 2 modules, and in my book just reinserted solid biofuel and gas filters into the processor unit, well, it's just way simpler than all this extra complexity, and it's still like several clicks, and actually clicking several clicks to turn something on and off, it's still several clicks. So yeah, there is no real reason for that complexity. With this information in mind, amount of sushi belt connections to module B from module A is increased to total of 7. This is why I placed 4 smart splitters for alien remains, well, on the edge of the factory. In this fashion, there is enough space for 3 more connections, which is, well, 4 plus 3 is a total of 7. Quite nice. Also, another neat trick is to make exterior of blueprint flush, and for this I am using conveyor lift hose and conveyor lifts for all 7 extensions. In this fashion I do not have like conveyor lift outlets, when you connect, you know, like conveyor lift and it's just sticking out on the side of the building, it's kinda sort of ugly. And in this fashion I can just make everything flush. So in this manner we will have 2 sets of connections. One side indentation for all imported connections that we are actually connecting to our blueprint. And there is a set of flush connections on the back for our sushi belt extension. With the module B, we need only to fit refinery, packager, 2 manufacturers, awesome sink and 1 constructor. Well, sounds kinda easy, but before you realize that, you know, like aluminum casing, quick wire, fabric, rubber, coal and alien protein with gas filters, well, they all require some sort of the buffer after sushi belt splits. So unlike in module A, I just use several smaller containers to make buffers in the module B because, well, the space is an issue there, and, well, the high tier items, they do not require like a lot of buffer space, so it's kinda alright. And the rest is kinda straightforward. Manufacturers fit on top of each other, and since I use the same container for storage of iodine filter and normal gas filters, I can just totally absolutely merge output of both manufacturers, so it's kinda neat trick there. Then the solid biofuel refinery fit directly into fuel packager, and also we have alien DNA constructor that is feeding directly into the awesome sink. A lot of things happening, but actually not a lot of logic there, so there is nothing really to explain. Only issue is to fit everything, but once again, just use your imagination and you will be fine. All connections between module A and B are done with the use of conveyor lifts and 1 simple water pipe. Then there is a single power connection in the side indentation, and most of the time every connection can be done by standing on the ground, so the setup is quite easy. And as I mentioned before, module A is basically independent and can be fully functional without module B, while module B is expansion for extra items with some of required connections like iron, coal and water, and once again coal can be actually produced in the module A, so the coal is an optional connection. Also, I was able to place equipment workshop inside of the factory right next to the power switch, so you just open the door and you have the access to the equipment workshop. The exterior design is once again my favorite Art Deco variation with brutalist beats here and there. It is quite similar to 3 previously released factories on my channel and feature red to yellow gradient. Basically, this factory wrapped a set of 4 basic factories for personal storage. Iron, heavy module frames, concrete and steel, and biomass encapsulators. Unlike my huge modular factories, they all are independent units and can be arranged in any form. Also, when I was making this factory, I sort of like realized that our in-game character in Satisfactory is sort of like vegetarian, right before the moment when you start to make inhalers from alien proteins. Yeah, well, I guess it's normal to inhale alien proteins in Sweden. like, share and subscribe. Have a nice one, and Yakis out.